This is the story of a man who never belonged anywhere, whose backyard is the world, whose ways of life are the dreams of escape for those who want action but never find it. The man, John Steele, adventurer. Most people spend most of their lives digging for wealth in one way or another. And only a few find it. Big money, that is. Well, I was around when it happened, when really big stuff was found. And you never know what greed can do until you're there to find out for yourself. I'd like to tell you what I found in a story I like to call Loser Sleeper. Pay, bonuses, all expenses paid, temporary foreign service for qualified personnel. That's what the ad said, the ad in the paper. I've never quite gotten over reading them. Well, the man at Interworld Airlines said the same thing, thanked me for answering the employment notice and made me an offer. That is, he did when he found out I knew about isobars, isotherms, and adiabatic rate. 3 weeks later, I was in Port Edward on Africa's Gold Coast, and it was hot. It was a small coastal port, growing now, because the airlines had come in and taken over the old military airbase. Nothing to see and do, but it served as a good refueling stop. I soon found Big Charlie's, the place where all the boys went after work. This one night, there was a fellow sitting next to me, and he wanted to talk.
You don't mind my butting in on your privacy, bud. You're American, right?
Right.
The tourist trade coming back?
Do I look like a tourist?
Yeah.
Thanks. Where are you from? Chicago?
Nope. Haven't been to the States for 10 years. Never gone back.
Well, I am. All you can do here is go home and sleep.
Miss the bright lights, eh?
No, I do miss having a little excitement now and then, I guess.
You've got the right places, that's all.
What do you mean? I know this town inside out.
Well, you come with me, you'll get excitement.
Where's that?
In.
What?
Away from the coast. In. We have to be smart to live, and not the kind of smart you find in polite society.
Sounds good.
I've been up to Kalmar's Pass, Shepherd's Plateau, know the jungle like a book.
Wow. What do you do? Hunt?
Hunt? Yeah, you might say that's just it, but I hunt. I hunt anything. Animals, precious stones, ivory, whatever I can find.
Had much luck?
Oh, some. One of these days I'll hit it big. Big. Then maybe I'll go back to the States.
Well, here's luck.
Thanks. No, you don't know what life is till you've been on a hike through the Black Gorlack country. Those babies are so mean they...
Pardon me.
Huh? Oh, hello.
I couldn't help but hear your conversation.
Now, we don't mind. Sit down.
Thank you.
Have a drink? Waiter.
No, thank you.
It's all right. My friend here works for Interworld, so he's got money.
I'll trade places with you anytime.
You can have it.
I didn't mean to interrupt anything.
You're not.
When you spoke about knowing the Shepherd Plateau...
I do, lady, like a...
I thought you might be able to help.
Help what?
Me.
Oh, there won't be, huh?
It's a business proposition, strictly.
Still interesting.
I wanted to be sure you understood.
I do. What's the job?
I want to go up on Shepherd's Plateau.
That's a long trip.
I don't care.
And a rope.
That doesn't matter.
What do you want to go there for?
I'll pay you £1,000 to take me there and back.
£1,000?
In American dollars, that ought to be about...
That's all I can give you.
You must want to go pretty bad.
I do.
£1,000.
Well?
When do you want to leave?
As soon as possible.
Whatever you say, you're paying for it.
How about me?
What about you?
Need an assistant?
You want to go?
I don't know much about the jungle, but I'm a good shot.
Well, you got a job.
I can get time off.
Want excitement, eh?
Well, I'd like to see what some of the rest of this continent has to offer.
Yeah, sorry, bud, but...
Just a moment.
Huh?
I think it's a good idea.
You want him to go?
I said I think it's a good idea.
Look, I'll have enough trouble watching over one tourist, much less...
You really want to make the trip?
Very much.
And you're a good shot?
I have a marksman.
All right. If you want, we'll take him. You're paying for it, lady.
Good. My name is Breckenridge.
I'm John Steele.
Look, Miss Breckenridge, you better tell me just where it is you want to go on Shepherd's Plateau. I got to get things together.
Here's a map with the place marked on it. I'll let you decide the best way to get there.
Now, you leave everything to me.
I will. I'm at the Bond Hotel. What time do you want to leave tomorrow?
Oh, about 5.
You'll pick me up?
I'll drop by.
I'll see you at 5. You too, Mr. Steele.
I'll be there.
Just a minute.
Yes?
I need a little, advance. Got to get together supplies, carriers. Don't expect me to finance it myself, do you?
No, of course not. Here, 500 now, 500 more pounds when we get back.
Fair enough.
In the morning at 5.
That's right.
Good night, gentlemen.
Well, now I can buy the drinks with a man.
Ah, I guess you can.
You're going to get your excitement all right.
Yes. Trusting soul, isn't she?
What do you mean?
She gives you 500 pounds and walks out.
So?
What's to stop you from walking out?
A lot of things, but...
I just wondered.
Here, look here on this map she gave me. You see that circle?
Yeah.
That's where she wants to go. Middle of nowhere. And I know the spot, I think. I want to find out why a dame like her will spend 1,000 pounds to get there. I guess I better figure the best way to travel first. I think we can get up to Whittlesley by car.
I got leave for my job, and the next morning we started off from the Bond Hotel in a couple of rented cars, loaded to the running boards with supplies and equipment. I thought you started breaking way through the wilds immediately. That's why the cars surprised me. We drove over 160 miles that day and stopped when the road ended abruptly at a trading post called Whittlesley. We spent the night there. Then loaded up our things in long boats and started to paddle up a wide, muddy river. I was in one boat with Miss Breckenridge. Hazlitt and a huge black native called Schutz was in the other. All that second day, we went upstream with few words spoken between us. It wasn't until almost sunset when she spoke directly to me.
It won't be pleasant to spend the night on the shore like that.
Have you been up here before, Miss Breckenridge?
Why do you ask?
Well, you don't seem to take notice of all the strange sounds, the scenery and everything.
Oh?
You act as if you'd seen it all your life.
Perhaps I have.
You don't look like you've spent much time in the tropics.
I haven't.
Let us go, Blackfellow.
I'll get us in.
Yes.
As if this is where we land.
Not good, Carter.
Get up on that bank.
Not good.
I'll show you.
Hazlitt's having trouble.
Yes.
He's ducking the boy.
Let's get ashore.
Sure.
You're gonna get up on that bank or do I choke your head so full of water?
That's enough, Bart.
I know what I'm
Let
doing.
Let him come up for air.
Let go my arm, will you?
You're drowning him.
I gotta do what he's saying.
Let him up.
Let go.
I said let him up.
Small brain, I'll twist your arm, see how you like it.
Come ahead.
Well, you got to teach these natives your boss. You can't get any work out of them.
That doesn't include drowning.
I was just teaching them
You were perfectly right, Mr. Hazlitt. It was the only thing you could do.
What?
Of course it was.
You'd let him drown this man?
I was just giving him a little...
What's the matter?
Shut up.
Sounds like drums.
It does.
Not good. Is he not?
Hand that bag out of the boat, quick.
What do you...
Get it.
Oh, all right. And this for one?
That's it. We won't get 2 miles through this jungle if we don't... There.
Not good, Bona.
Looks like a drum.
What are you going to...
Quiet.
They're answering you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, that's quite a trick.
Quiet. Now, we can take it easy. We'll get a poisoned arrow in our back.
Friends?
Yeah, friends.
Jungle telegraph system.
Not good.
Shut up, you. All right, Steele, let's get to work.
The beginning of danger and a piece of the unknown. There's much of these when in a moment we hear more in the story of John Steele, adventurer.
The tropic night came quickly, almost before we got the tent set up on the riverbank. And later, as I lay there under the mosquito netting, I heard the drums begin again far off in the jungle. All night they beat out their messages. Morning, and as we broke camp and started through the heavy growth inland, they seemed to follow us through the green wilderness. At night, Bart would take out his drum and answer those in the distance. While he beat on the drumhead, the woman, Faye Breckenridge, would stare at him across the fire as if hypnotized, with never a glance at me or the native, Carlo. On the third day, we followed a path up the side of a rocky cliff until we finally reached what Bart called Shepherd's Plateau. Once on top, The going was easier through the tall grasses that covered the land as far as I could see, but the drums stayed with us. Bart gave me a rifle and put me last in line to watch for big cats, which he claimed were numerous in the area. And trailing the column, I got into trouble. The shock nearly broke my neck, and I swung at the end of a vine-like rope, head down under a tall, half-bent tree. I'd read about snares, a loop in a bent tree for a spring, and now I knew about them firsthand. I yelled for help and tried to pull myself high enough to reach the rope, but I couldn't make it. Somewhere nearby, I heard a drum beating, much closer than before, beating almost like a voice of triumph. Then I was free and fell head first into the grass. Carlo was sliding down the tree trunk, knife in hand.
You good, Bonner? Not hurt?
I think not. It got me by surprise.
Go already quick to catch up with others.
Thanks for cutting me down. I felt like a trapped animal.
Go hurry fast.
What's the rush?
Wazhiki country. Drums.
The drums? Well, those are friends.
Not friends.
Of course they are.
Wazhiki set trap. Now get...
What's the matter?
Here.
That arrow.
Pull out.
I'll get it out, sure. Hold still. It's not bad. Just through the flesh.
Pull out.
Wait a minute, I am. I'll break the shaft. Push the arrowhead through. There. That's got it. Sorry if it hurt too much. You're right. We better get on to the others. Someone around here doesn't like us. Come on. Well, are you coming?
In your home.
What's the matter with you?
Arrow from Wazhiki.
We'll get another if you stick around here.
You'll come.
Ah, that's more like it. Thanks for coming back when I yelled. I might have hung forever in that tree.
Not long, die soon.
Yeah, I suppose so. Didn't Bart and Miss Breckenridge hear me?
They no stop.
No, I guess they didn't. Funny, they didn't get caught up in the thing.
Boss wanna go around it.
What?
He see rope and grass with bent tree. Take White Missy round side.
Oh, I see.
Not good.
But he didn't warn me.
In your hut.
What do you mean by that?
Not good.
I know. Not good. But thanks, anyway. Come on, we better catch up with the others. This Bart is tricky. If Bart Hazlitt was surprised when we caught up to them, he didn't show it. Maybe I was wrong, because I couldn't think of a single reason why he'd want to get rid of me. I was just a stranger along for the ride. And the arrow in Carlo's flesh showed me that maybe Bart had friends out there in the drums. But that didn't mean they were my friends, too. Maybe he'd simply forgotten to warn me about the snare. And maybe it was a mistake, that arrow hitting Carlo. It might have been for me. I was going to be careful from here on. It was that afternoon when Bart called a halt, map in hand, and we gathered around him.
All right, Faye, here's where you wanted to come.
Is it?
According to the map.
Well, I don't see anything different.
You sure this is the place?
Told you know this land like a book. Here's the four trees called for on the map.
Well, I don't see why anyone would want to come here.
Could be reasons, huh, Faye?
Yes.
Well?
Which way is north?
North?
Yes.
There, toward the sun.
There ought to be a... Yes.
Ought to be what?
Right over there.
Come on.
Just a pile of rock.
Help me pull the top ones away.
Yeah, I'll help you. I'll help you.
Yes.
After all these years.
There should be a metal box. It's
gotta be here.
I don't get it.
A little deeper, maybe.
That might be it.
Might be what?
Yeah, that's it.
Still intact.
What is it?
Gotta open it, be sure.
Give me the box, Hazlitt.
Where's the answer? Can I open it?
What's this all about?
We'll see.
What's in it?
Give it to me.
It's him. All of them.
Give them to me, Bart.
What are they?
Give them to me, Bart.
I knew if I waited longer.
They look like little pebbles.
Pebbles?
They're rock diamonds.
What?
I looked and I'd never found them.
But now you're not going to keep them.
Not
going
to keep them?
No, Bart.
They're mine.
They never were yours.
Thought I didn't know who you were. I knew the minute you handed me the map.
You still don't know.
And you walked up and hired me. Me, the one guy you wanted to miss.
I didn't want to miss you. I was looking
Miss
for
Breckenridge,
you.
Miss Breckenridge, Bart here has something that belongs to you.
I wasn't sure you were the one till you went ashore in that clearing.
Yeah?
I wanted you to come along. Do you understand? I wanted it to be you.
Well, it's over now. I don't have to wait anymore. Don't come any closer.
You better put that gun down.
Get back.
That won't do any good.
It's going to do a lot of good.
Look, if you just tell me what
to take these after I've been waiting all this time. Oh,
you're
no.
Crazy, Hazlitt.
Now, you can run while I just... Got him.
Get that gun out of his hand before it goes off again.
Hold good.
Now, get up, Hazlitt. Get up.
All right. Now what you gonna do?
I got your pebbles, Faye. Thanks, Carlo.
Now what you gonna do?
What'll it be, Faye?
Kill him.
Now, wait a minute.
He deserves it.
I have no doubt of that, but that's a job for the law.
He's a murderer. That's why I brought you along to kill him.
Well, you brought the wrong guy.
I'm beginning to see that.
Carlo and I'll get you back to Port Edward. We'll let Bart here come along. In front of us.
Go ahead, try and get back. I'm staying here.
All right, stay. We can get back without you.
You can try.
Carlo will help us.
Babe's in the woods.
I'm a good shot, I told you. Get back.
Just want to pick up my pack. You wouldn't want to leave me without anything, would you?
You can have your pack, but that's all now. I'll leave the gun for you at the edge of the plateau.
Mana.
Yes?
Not good.
What's not good?
Not leave White Boss here.
Why not?
Ingaho.
Now listen. I've been patient enough.
Go ahead. Get back without me if you can.
Come on, Fay.
You ought to kill him. We're not safe if he's...
Sorry. I'm not that kind. Are you coming?
Yes.
Well, Johnny.
What?
Watch out for the snares. I thought the last one had saved me the trouble. Now I'll let the jungle do my work for me.
Come on, Fay.
You have the diamonds?
In my pocket.
Keep them there.
I will. What's that for?
I don't know.
It's Bart on his drum.
He's signaling, I think.
Talk with Wachiki.
Oh, that native tribe?
Bad people. Go hurry fast.
Will they do what he says?
Not good.
Yes, they will. Bart Hazlitt is the only white man who's been able to make friends with them.
Then without Bart...
We'd better travel as fast as we can.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
At night, too.
Can you stand it?
I can.
Let's go.
Suspense and action. One leads to the other. The result we'll hear in just a moment with the climax of another adventure with John Steele.
We made good time back across the plateau, down the side of the cliff and into the jungle below. But no matter how fast we could travel, even if we could have run across the treetops like the monkeys above us, we couldn't have outrun the drums. They were always behind us. As we went through the night, we could hear them beginning on one side of us, too. Bart's drum had told them something, and they were taking his orders. I didn't have to use my imagination to know what those orders were. It was hard going, but Faye seemed to be holding up remarkably well. It was a native boy, Carlo, that surprised me. Each step he took was becoming harder for him, and I could see lines of pain forming on his face. His lips were clamped tight, and he shook his head when I tried to question him. Carlo couldn't fail on us now. We'd never get back to the river without him. I don't know how long we fought our way through the jungle, resting only a few hours at night, then pushing on behind Carlo's unsteady lead. All I remember are the drums. And there were voices, too, chanting softly. So softly you weren't sure they were there. It was nearly morning when Carlo finally dropped to the ground in front of us.
No good.
Are we near the river?
River up there. Boat.
We better hurry.
Come on, Carlo. Get up.
You'll go, I die here.
What?
Now I die.
You're not going to die.
A cheeky arrow, I die.
That was just a flesh wound,
wasn't it? Was he hit with an arrow?
Yes, not badly. Just after we got up on the plateau.
Why didn't you tell me?
Well, I didn't think it was...
Washiki arrows are poisoned. You can't survive a hit in the body.
He didn't tell me.
Well, we couldn't have done anything anyway except make him comfortable. If the wound is in the body, there's no hope.
Go to river. Washiki drums.
John.
Yes?
You notice the difference?
The drums?
They're coming from the river, too.
Yeah, all around us.
Well, we tried.
Now we'll have to fight.
No fight. Kill quick.
They're coming closer.
Sit tight. I'll fix it so they'll... Wait. Carlo. Carlo.
Why not?
I know you've done a lot for us, but you've got to do just one more thing.
I die.
Can you talk to them, Carlo? Can you make them understand?
I try. I can talk.
All right, listen. Tell them if they don't go away, I'll bring rain, heavy rain, very quick, fast.
You make rain.
Yeah, that's it.
But sun bright.
There's just a few clouds overhead.
Can you do it? Tell them I will bring strong rain if they do not go.
I come.
I'll call them. Hey! Hey, you! Wait! Listen! All right. Tell him, Carlo.
Mornon! Mornon! Villano! Signor! Mornon! Villano! Signor!
You think they heard?
Of course they did.
I hope it works.
It'll only give us time.
All I need is time.
They'll wait for a little while out of curiosity. Then when the rain doesn't come, they'll get impatient. Oh, it's no use, John. It's just prolonging
it. It's our one chance to get to those boats.
I knew it was a good impulse to have you come along. At least you've tried.
Well, it's lucky Carlo here could speak. Carlo.
Dead.
He lived just long enough.
Yeah, just long enough. Are your pebbles worth it?
No, John.
We sat there, beside the body of Carlo, and looked out at the undergrowth, neither saying a word. All around us, we could feel eyes looking in on us, waiting. There wasn't a sound from the jungle except chattering of birds and monkeys. You'd never know 100 or more little men with spears, arrows, and drums were crouched around us in a huge circle. It was too quiet. Then the drums started as their patience wore out. There wasn't going to be enough time. Faye was right. The idea had only prolonged the ending. I picked up the rifle, cocked it, and pulled extra rounds of ammunition out of the pack. It was a full place for a fight, but there wasn't any choice. The drums were getting stronger now, and I could feel the circle moving in. There wasn't enough time. Any moment, the arrows would pour in from the brush around us, and the little men would pour after me. I lifted the rifle, ready to shoot at the first target I saw. Then the sun went out as a heavy black cloud swept over it, and the drums broke their rhythm. A moment later, the rain started, suddenly, heavily.
Rain, John, rain!
Head for the river.
Wonderful rain!
Over this way.
Rain!
Gotta get on the river before they recover.
I can see the water.
The boats ought to be here. But there it is. There's one. Come on. Get in. I got it untied.
I'm in.
Lie down on the boat, just in case.
It's all right. They won't follow out of their own territory.
I'm not so sure.
That's what Father said.
Your father?
He sent me, John.
To get the diamonds?
Yes, and to find Bart Hazlitt. There wasn't anybody else to send. Father and my brother Jack were here before the war, prospecting for diamonds. Bart went in on a partnership with them. When they started home after hitting a strike, Bart killed my brother. Tried to kill Father.
Oh, I see.
Father hid the box of diamonds up on the plateau so that Bart couldn't kill him for them. That's why Father couldn't come himself.
Why?
Well, Bart tortured him to find where they'd been hid. He hasn't been able to walk since. It was his word against my father's, so no court would ever convict Bart.
And you were going to lure him into the jungle, kill him some way.
Well, that was my idea, not Father's. He just wanted the diamonds.
You could have done it.
I know.
But you didn't. Why?
I couldn't. I wasn't man enough.
You mean you weren't animal enough? Well, I'll give you what you came after, and you can have them. You're dying.
Something wrong?
Well, I had them in this pocket. The lower seam is ripped.
They're gone.
Dribbled out back there in the jungle. Just one left. Small one.
Well, that's that.
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
At least you can have the police pick up Bart when he comes out. I'll back up any charges you make. Maybe not for your brother's murder, but there's plenty of others we can make.
Yes.
Here. You keep this last pebble as evidence.
No, you keep it, John. You might need it sometime.
Thanks. Maybe I will. Pina, huh?
You don't say it quite right. I'll have to teach you. If you tell me how you knew it was going to rain.
Well, you've forgotten. I'm a weatherman. Now, you see, when the dew point is high, then you have a certain cloud formation, which in the tropics is known as a secondary cold. Now, this rushes into the low pressure area.